Hello everyone. Dmitry Pobedinsky is with you. I am glad to welcome you to my channel. An interesting contest awaits you at the end. Well, now, I think you guessed it. One of my favorite superheroes is Iron Man. According to the film, he was injured in the explosion and since then there is an electromagnet in his chest that prevents the fragments of the bomb from getting into his heart. And all this is powered by a device that looks very much like a thermonuclear reactor, only very miniature. Agree, a beautiful idea. But how real is this at all? Is it possible to implant something like this into a person? Well, or even replace the entire heart with a device powered by nuclear energy? Let's figure it out. Just a little upset. The existing thermonuclear reactors are huge colossuses, as high as a multi-story building. Now, of course, compact versions are being developed, but they will also be the size of a truck, so it is unlikely that it will fit in a person. Well, only if so. But I think it's not very convenient. Besides, there are a lot of problems. Thermonuclear fusion is the process of fusion of atomic nuclei, and they are always positive and repel each other. Therefore, the temperature should be more than 10 million degrees. Only then do the nuclei move so fast that they can overcome the repulsion. So hot a substance must be held in the air so that it does not melt. All this is done with the help of strong magnetic fields. And a lot of energy is spent on this. So much so that only in the 2014 year it was possible to get more power from the reactor than it spent. By this time, the third film had already been released. By the way, and you must agree, it is not clear why Tony Stark still does not have a Nobel Prize, because he was able to get around all these problems, and even in such a compact case. So we are unlikely to be able to recreate the Iron Man technology in reality yet. But do not worry, because you can use nuclear energy to work the heart. How can you be so sure? Yes, it's just doing it already. Look, this is an implantable cardio stimulator that generates electrical impulses for a stable heartbeat. And notice, what's the icon there? Yes, 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 it's not photoshopped. In the 70s of the last century, pacemakers appeared using radioactive plutonium-238 as a power source. It contains very little of it there, no more than 0.2 grams. But this stock is enough for a long time. Some of them are still working, and this is more than 40 years. Just imagine, you have a capsule with a radioactive substance in your chest. Wow! Of course, it is reliably protected even from a direct bullet hit, and the radiation background from the device is minimal. But, despite all this coolness and the plus of such a solution, the technology still did not catch on. Firstly, because of the appearance of devices on lithium-ion batteries, which also work for quite a long time. Well, secondly, being afraid of people before radiation, it is very difficult to eradicate. It is worth noting that these were not miniature nuclear reactors. A chain reaction in such a small volume cannot occur. To do this, you need a mass not less than the critical mass for plutonium, that's 11 kilograms. Basically, the following was used in them. Due to the natural radioactive decay, the substance was heated, and this heat was converted into electricity. The efficiency, of course, is lower than at a nuclear power plant. But we're not launching an icebreaker here, you know, we need just a little bit. In general, in the 70s there was a project of an entire artificial heart, in which there were several tens of grams in a semitone. The heat of radioactive decay heated the gas, which, expanding, pushed the piston and drove the pump pumping blood. Unfortunately, the project had to be closed for the same reasons as nuclear pacemakers. But still, looking at the available developments, it becomes clear that the atomic heart may well exist. But the technology has not sunk into oblivion. It is called Rydic, a radioisotope thermoelectric generator. Now it is used mainly in spacecraft that are sent to deep space, where solar panels are no longer effective. The Rydic is refueled with several kilograms of Pluto and such a space battery serves for a very long time, several decades. And interestingly, if retags can be so different sizes, then why not put one in a smartphone? It's cool, then we'll forget about charging at all, bite Apple with your wires. And there are such projects. They use not plutonium, but the third of the hydrogen sinks. These are called beta volt current sources, and their service life can reach up to 20 years. In them, the third beta radiation is absorbed by semiconductors and converted into electricity, and bypassing the transition to heat, which only increases efficiency. The technology is, of course, expensive, but very promising. So, I think sooner or later we will see smartphones that do not need to be charged at all. Poor background, there will be no connectors at all. By the way, now you can easily buy a radioactive keychain. Seriously, it uses the same third of his wood. This radiation is absorbed by the phosphor layer and re-emitted as light. Such a device has been working for several years and is completely safe, because the energy of this radiation would not be enough to pass through the walls of the case. As you can see, the range of applications of nuclear technologies is incredibly wide, and development in this direction is slow. Partly because everyone is terribly afraid of radiation. But it's worth noting, yes, she is really dangerous. But we are used to such dangers as electricity, gas stove, airplanes. So a real Iron Man may well be only a matter of time. Well, I wish you all good luck. See you in the next issues and thanks for watching.